Monkey.
Why?
Monkey. You have shown me, monkey. Monkey.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of TSF Reviews. Today, we are going to be taking on Hitmonkey. I'm joined here today by Suhaib, Junaid, and Amr. And I am the ghost of Bryce? I forgot his name, but he was in the show.
Bryce. Yeah, Bryce.
Hitmonkey is a show on Hulu, and we enjoyed it. Better than MODOK, which we will never review because that is a horrible show. I refuse to watch it, even like past the first minute. Nope, that is the worst thing ever. But this, I came in here with no expectations. I'm like, this is going to be another show like that. But then when I started watching it, it was a fun watch. I really enjoyed this show. So, hey, what do you think?
Yeah, I agree with you on both fronts. First of all, about MODOK, which I had the bad luck to watch the entire first episode. But when you suggested Hitmonkey to me, I watched that first episode and I never went back to MODOK again. The difference being that this was enjoyable. And then I kept watching. This was just 10 episodes, but it was a fun one-time watch. There were problems at the end, sure. The ending didn't sit well with me because, just too much happened that didn't make sense for me. But overall, a good, fun one-time watch. JD?
Yeah, okay. I didn't even know about MODOK, so I'm on a bind. So anyways, Hitmonkey, it was good. I enjoyed it, but yeah, it had some problems, but okay, it was a combination. I will say it's a combination of two or three things. One is you put Planet of the Apes and you merge it with the Outsider, Jared Leto version, and you get the Hitmonkey. And the ghost thing, I'm forgetting the movie, but it's a combination of that as well. Good one-time watch. It was a small episode runtime, so it was easy to go through. So that's what I would say. Amir.
All right, then. Genuinely a good show. It wasn't too amazing. Didn't blow me out of my mind. I cannot say that I noticed anything particularly that upset me. But then again, the moment I watched the first episode, I grounded my expectations that this is just going to be a joyride of a show that I am not supposed to put too much brain energy on. And maybe I suppose that is one thing you can say is bad. Some things that you guys mention about the ending episode, there were some characters in there that weren't particularly I will say they weren't given enough screen time for me. I didn't get to know those characters all that well. Specifically talking about the Silver Samurai, who I know is someone from Marvel. Please correct me if I'm wrong, since I'm not a fanboy, right?
He is, yes.
And the ghost protector of Tokyo, Azuki, that, oh my God, what an amazing character. But I don't know anything about her, except that she fights Monkey for 5 minutes, and then she's like, oh, you're honorable, so you get to live. So some gripes I have with the show. Nothing particularly upsetting about it. It was fun to watch. If it wasn't, I would have been, mad at Mubarak for suggesting this. But yeah, the comic relief that it provided, the comedy dialogues between Bryce and the monkey,
Yes.
That was enjoyable. So stuff that I like is the main characters, the two boys. Stuff I didn't like is everyone else is just there to, support the story and be nothing else. They're just plot tools. So, yeah.
Yeah, so I guess it's because Marvel, Hulu especially, did not know if people were going to watch this show based on MODOK. They were like, you know what, let's not risk it. Let's just put a little bit of Easter eggs in there, just a little bit, just to get the fans, you know, who read the comics and all that, get them excited. Like, with all those references and Easter eggs, you saw, like, a lot of people in there, Silver Samurai, and then you have other people in there. You know, there were fun Easter eggs to go through. But one thing in particular that I really, really enjoyed about this is the music they've used. They went with authentic Japanese hip-hop and rap sort of thing. You know, like, you could tell that they, and even the voice acting, they tried their best to go with authentic Japanese pronunciations and voice actors. That is something really, really nice. Also, the main voice actor, Jason Sudeikis, sorry if I'm butchering that name, quite enjoyable as, Bryce. He had a very Archer or Ryan Reynolds feel to him, but he was actually quite enjoyable as the character.
I am going to second Mubarak's point about the music.
Yeah.
Sorry, go on. Sorry.
If there's ever a live action adaptation, we all know who is going to be playing Bryce.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because Bryce, and fun fact, Bryce was the name of Ryan Reynolds' character in Hitman's
Bodyguard. Well. Yeah. Yeah. I remember. That's a fun review we did as well. You can check it out. We'll have a link somewhere. Yeah, but hey, what is one thing that you liked about this show?
The ending. The ending was weird for me. You said like or dislike?
Go on. This is fun.
I'm going for the didn't like option because I didn't hear you fully.
No, it's okay. Go on.
But the ending, especially with the new Lady Bullseye.
Yeah, that was weird.
You know, it was rushed. I mean, one minute she just absolutely adores this monkey, and then the next she's like, "I'm going to do whatever it takes to kill the monkey." After knowing the truth about her uncle, it didn't make much sense to me. I mean, it was rushed. If they had to keep Lady Bullseye, like, keep her alive, whatever, you know, make her a different character for all I care. But, you know, this didn't make much sense to me. Really?
Yeah. Especially after that weird love dynamic they had, monkey and human. Like, I was like, it reminded me of the B movie, and I'm like, oh no, are they gonna cross that line? Are they? Like, wow.
Oh no.
Okay, we're going with dislikes. No. JD, what did you dislike about this show?
Okay, how can I count which is the most disliked moment? One thing is they rushed the whole fight scene. I mean, Silver Samurai came out of nowhere and he just became the hero of the show without no background or anything else. Then, you know, the Lady Bullseye, I mean, at least if you're going to make her a villain, just make it from the start. The third thing was the B-movie scene. I mean, if you're going to do it, just do it. Don't tease it. Yani, it's weird. It's rated R plus. It's not rated R. I don't know. It's all over the place. So
it's all over the R. Just barely under the X.
It's not directly under it. Other than that, it's all over.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah.
What about you, Amar? Any dislikes?
I did mention out that some of the major characters, they just felt like plot tools. When I say major characters, I'm not talking about the politician girl whose name I obviously forgot, the the two police officers, not them. I mean, Azuki, Silver Samurai. Silver Samurai shows up at the end.
No, he had a cameo in episode 3, I believe, or episode 2. There was a cameo, and he is, like, if you see that one scene, it's very obvious that he is celebrity.
I am someone who has not read any comic, but I didn't pick that up.
So it was
when
in
he
that
showed
one
up
scene,
at
yeah.
the end, when he showed up at the end for just like, oh hi, I also exist. The only reason I know who Silver Samurai is because Umar told me about it. That's the only reason I know that there exists this character in Marvel. And like, if I didn't know, I would be like, who the heck? Who are you?
Exactly.
Bro?
Who the heck are you?
So yeah. Like I said, it's not the greatest show. I don't hold it against it because I didn't have any major expectations of it, not in a bad sense. I did have an enjoyable time watching the show. I have not watched the other one, Mordok or whatever.
I hope you never do.
Yeah, well, considering you said that, I probably never will. But yeah, I did not have any expectations going in. So now that I've come out of it, it's a generally good show.
Yeah,
I guess we should give it our numbers.
You know, I'm hoping that this remains a one season sort of thing. There's no point of a season 2. You've had your fun, you've had a good run, but do we really need a season 2 of the show? Especially now that we know the villain just picked up the mask and put it on, and now she's the villain.
Because otherwise, you know, they would have kept Bryce up for at least the second season. Mm. You know, if they were even thinking about it. But the fact that they've brought Bryce back, and you know, they're building up a villain, so they're probably thinking of season 2.
They probably are, and yeah, they probably will. All right, let's talk scores. Sohaib, your score first.
It's tough. I mean, you know, for a one-time watch, it was fun. It's a very binge-worthy show.
Yeah.
That you could, you know, just binge the entire thing and it would still be enjoyable. And I would give it like an 8.5 to a 9, cutting the extra mark just for the ending.
All right. Fair enough. Junaid?
I've already told you this before. It's a 9 for me. Because there were issues, but it's a binge-worthy show and you can just watch it without having, you know, like the feeling of, again. So it's a good show, but it's a one-time show. It's a 9.
All right, Amir, your score.
I give it a 7 out of 10. It's, like everyone says, it's a binge-worthy show. It's a good watch, enjoyable. Nothing extraordinary. So you will enjoy it, have fun watching it. Just don't expect to be blown away. Yeah.
And now comes the biggest upset. You know, usually I'm the critical one here, but this time Amir gave it a 7 and I'm giving it a 9. First of all, I was born Year of the Monkey, so I have special connections to monkeys anyways. I probably look like
bias.
One as well.
Bias.
Yeah, but no, I genuinely enjoyed this show. I give it a 9 despite the, you know, the ending and other stuff like that. Like, if this is a one season thing, that's a definite 9 for me. If you're going to drag this on for a few more seasons, I'll probably lower my score. But for now, it's a 9 for me. Anyways, I guess that's it. Thank you all for watching. And we'll see
Monkey
you show. Next time.
Subscribe, like, watch the other videos. Subscribing really helps us, you know? It's a secret that YouTube doesn't want you to know.
Or else the monkey will come and get you.
Yeah. All right. See you.
Okay. Bye.
Take care.
Bye.